You don't need to have thousands of hours of practice to make realistic grass in Blender. At first, when I started doing 3D, I took 6 months to do my first realistic scene because I thought I wouldn't be able to do it. But I swear it's much easier than you think. You'll not need to have any add-on or plugin for this video, but you'll need to have an Epic Game account for Quixel Bridge, unless you know how to make your own foliage, but we're not gonna cover that into this video because it's gonna be so long and I don't even know if I can do that. Before doing anything in Blender, you're gonna want to have references, so go on Google Image. It's super important to know what you want because you can quickly add things that doesn't blend well together. When you know what you want, hop in Blender, create a plan and scale it up a bit. Then in Quixel Bridge, you can select the 3D plants of your choice. What I like to do is to select one main grass that will mainly cover my ground, and then I select around two variety of flowers or plants. Personally, I'm gonna go with the wild grass, the red fountain grass, and the periwinkle. I don't know how to pronounce that. By the way, don't copy me. Well, I mean, you can copy me. I won't come to your house and stop you, but try your own things. Grass in 3D doesn't have really rules, so you can really test your own things, and it's by trying that you'll see what's good and what's not. You can try to tweak the settings. You don't have to follow every numbers I'm gonna put. Like, it's really up to you. Import them to your scene and be sure the textures are connected to the right effect. If you're on cycles, you'll probably want to change your feature set from supported to experimental. I don't know if it's still happening in the last versions, but before, Quixel Bridge will not connect the textures to the right nodes when you were unsupported. So be sure your roughness is in roughness, normal in your normal, opacity in your alpha, and translucent in your transmission. Also, boost your light paths a little tiny bit in transparent and transmission. I sometimes add bugs of shadow when those were low. Create a 6 feet cube for reference and select every plant of one asset, like the wild grass asset for example, and press M to put them into a collection. You can now create a particle system on your plane. Select hair and under the render section, change path to collection and choose your main grass. Go under source and select random distribution, and really important, check the use modifier stack. Otherwise, your particles will not follow with the modifiers, and that's not what you want. Change the scale as much as you want, but don't forget to add some scale randomness. This will add a lot to your scene. Don't put too much though, because grass is probably not supposed to look super tiny. Now, if you want to put grass on a large scale, you'll probably want to select interpolated under children. You can play with the settings, but you mainly want to play with those two settings. Display amount is the amount of grass in your viewport, and render is in your render. That's right, you're following. You can check the pick random box under collection, and if you want better performance, lower the display amount of your particles because we basically finished with the main grass. Now we can create another particle system, select the same grass particle we had and duplicate it. Rename it for your new one, and in collection, select your new collection of flowers. For this one, I'll add more scale randomness because I feel like tiny flowers is not unrealistic. When you're happy with your flowers or your plants, duplicate again and select your other asset if you have another one. Make the scale look good, and we're done for that step. Now we're gonna pick a grass texture for our plane. I'll go with this one because it looks like the asset I took. Import it and unplug the displacement node for now. We're gonna fix it later, and you can scale down the mapping if you need it. We don't mind if the texture repeats itself. We're not gonna notice it since we got a lot of ground covering. It's now starting to look like something, but we're gonna take this a little bit further. Select your plane and go into your vertex groups and create a main grass group. In your particle system, go in vertex groups and select the one you just made. Subdivide your plane in the edit mode, and now it's time for painting, so go in weight painting mode and start to make a little random pattern. Basically, what you want is an ununiform pattern where you have spots where you got more grass and spots where you have less grass, because I like to think that grass doesn't grow the same everywhere, and you can create different patterns for the other assets. Next, go in your modifiers of your plane and get a displace. Place it on top of your particle system, otherwise they will not be affected by it. Create a new texture and select clouds. Set the scale between 1 and 2. We can't see it in my screen, but I've chosen 1.7. And now it's too big, but the most important part here is to not panic, because what we only have to do is decrease the strength of the displace modifier. Again, we can't see what I've set mine to, but it's minus 0.14, and there you go. You got a good looking bumpy ground for grass. Plug back the displacement node of your grass texture of the plane and decrease the scale very low. I know it looks very sharp, but hey, focus. We just need to add a little subdivision modifier under the displace one. And like the dumbass I am, again, you can't see what I've set mine to, but it's around 5. But it really depends on the scale of your plane. If your plane is very large, you'll want more vertex. If your plane is very low, you'll want Les Vertex, yeah.
Oh my god, it's the scene where Scorpion and Sub-Zero enter the boat. God damn, they used to scare me so much when I was young. Now you'll be able to see the real scale of your displacement node and set it to the correct one, set a sunlight, and there you go! What, are you not happy with what we made? Okay, I'ma give it to you, it doesn't really look realistic, but our problem is not the grass itself, but like everything around the grass. And unfortunately, I'm not gonna be able to explain everything I'm gonna do to make this grass look good, but the most important thing for your grass to look good is lighting. Lighting is the thing you can't miss. So get a good HDRI or an add-on that can make a good sky, set the depth of field on your camera, put a cube of fog, pimp your compositor with some glare nodes, lens dirt, grain, do a little bit of color correct, set up a bigger environment to boost your composition with plane instead of models to boost your performance, and voila! Okay, it's not really a huge environment, but it's just a little thing to show what you can do with such a simple particle system. Anyway, if you have any problems or bugs, anything, you can write a comment down below. You can explain what's your bug to me. I'm gonna try to solve it. Maybe I can, I don't know. I'm not a pro, but I'm gonna try my best. I'll answer to anyone, and please leave a like if you can. It really helps me more than you think. Subscribe if this video helped you. I plan on making more videos like that. And that's about it. See you guys.